Hello, welcome to European Open Briefing for Tuesday, February 27th. I'm Rafi Boyajian, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be having a look at what's happening in the currency markets today. The US dollar is relatively steady this morning, ahead of that very important testimony by the new Fed Chair Jerome Powell. Everyone's anxious to see what Powell will be saying about the US economy, especially after the recent data showing a potential uptick in inflation, as well as the market volatility that we had over the past month. We are seeing some risk sentiment this morning, though. Global stocks are extending their rebound. We had a very strong close in Wall Street yesterday as Treasury yields in the US fell back. The market participants are at the moment betting on Powell not sounding overly hawkish, so that's improving risk sentiment at the moment. The euro is slightly up this morning. We've got some important political events coming up at the end of the week, mainly the Italian elections. The pound was boosted yesterday on the back of hawkish remarks by a Bank of England policymaker. We've got more speeches coming up that could potentially move the pound. We've got Governor Mark Carney speaking later in the week, as well as Theresa May, UK Prime Minister. She'll be making another important Brexit speech. Let's now turn to the markets. We can see dollar has just about broken above the 107 level. It's been hovering around that level for some time now. We can see the euro slightly firmer. The pound has given up earlier gains. It's slightly flat on the day at the moment. Aussie and the Kiwi are both weaker, and so is the loonie. Gold is slightly up, but oil prices are slightly weaker this morning, and we can see those strong gains yesterday overnight on Wall Street. Dow Jones and S&P both up by 1%. Europe is fairly mixed this morning. The FTSE is slightly up, and German and French indices are relatively flat as well. We can see, though, that the Nikkei in Japan closed at 1%, but in China, shares fell rather sharply. Let's turn to the dollar now. We can see that the rebound that we saw from those multi-year lows, the three-year low for dollar index and the 50-month low for dollar yen in mid-February, that recovery has somewhat halted. We can see that consolidation since last week taking place. The dollar index currently hovering around 89.70 and dollar yen around 107 level. 10-year Treasury yields are down sharply, though, from last week. They rose to a near four-year high of 2.957%. They're currently trading around 2.86%. So although that is weighing on the dollar, it is helping equities. The focus will be, of course, what Jerome Powell will be saying in his first semi-annual monetary policy testimony before Congress. It's going to be testifying before the House of Representatives and before the Senate tomorrow. So everyone's eager to see what he's going to be saying about the inflation outlook in the US following the recent strong data, as well as whether or not he's going to try to reassure markets that if there is further volatility, the Fed might not raise rates as aggressively. So we don't really know too much what his exact views are, though. Although most analysts expect him not to stray too far from Janet Yellen's views. It's going to be a lot of data as well this week for the US. We've got durable goods orders and consumer confidence numbers coming up later today. Tomorrow we're going to see the second estimate of fourth quarter GDP. And on Thursday we're going to see the personal consumption expenditures numbers, including personal income and spending, as well as the Fed's preferred inflation measure, the PCE Core Price Index. And the ISM manufacturing PMI as well. So all of those are due on Thursday. So those could potentially boost the dollar if they show that US growth remains solid and inflation is indeed moving higher. Let's take a look at the euro now, because the euro has retreated rather sharply from those highs early in the month of a 3-year top of 1.2555. The euro, though, has been slowly edging upwards from last week's lows. It's currently trading around 1.2330. Yesterday, we had ECB President Mario Draghi speaking in the European Parliament. So, although he was fairly confident about the Eurozone economic outlook, he did say that the evolution of inflation remains crucially conditional on ample degree of monetary stimulus. So, that led to many analysts to believe that the ECB could potentially extend its QE program beyond September 2018, when the current program expires. Inflation data will be in focus this week. We've got German flash inflation numbers coming up late today, as well as the Eurozone flash release expected tomorrow, though they are unlikely to change the near-term inflation outlook. The bigger risks will be the Italian elections on Sunday, on March the 4th. The centre-right coalition there is currently ahead in the polls. But even if the Five Star Movement were to win the elections, they're less of a threat now because they've softened their anti-EU stance. So that risk has somewhat diminished, but it could, if we do see inconclusive election results on Sunday, it could potentially lead to prolonged uncertainty in the Eurozone's third largest economy. Also on Sunday will be the SPD party will be voting on whether or not to go ahead with the coalition deal with the Angela Merkel CDU party. The CDU party yesterday voted in favor of that coalition deal. The SPD, of course, isn't so sure about it. So although it's unlikely, there is the possibility of an upset on Sunday if the SPD party votes against another coalition deal with Angela Merkel. Let's take a quick look at the UK pound, because we did see a bit of a boost for sterling yesterday. It rose above $1.40. We had over the weekend an interview by the Bank of England's Deputy Governor, Dave Ramsden, who's actually the bank's one of the most dovish members, and he was fairly hawkish. He said he sees the need, the case for rates rising somewhat sooner than somewhat later due to a pickup in wage growth. The Governor Mark Carney will also be speaking later this week on Friday. On Friday, another highlight will be Prime Minister Theresa May's speech on the future EU-UK relationship. She is under pressure regarding how close trade links to have with the EU. The Labour opposition party wants to the UK to stay to or have some sort of a customs union with the EU. May doesn't agree with this. Yet later today, the Trade Secretary Liam Fox will be giving another Brexit speech. He will be saying that he will be giving the reasons why the UK shouldn't stay in a customs union, and we're also going to hear from the European Union. This is going to be the European Union's first draft outline of what kind of a Brexit withdrawal agreement it wants to have with the EU. So that's going to be published tomorrow. We might hear some details about that, though, before that, later today. So a lot of Brexit in the headlines of the coming week. For now, though, sterling is fairly firm, just below the $1.40 level. Let's move on to the Canadian dollar and the New Zealand dollar. We can see the loonie did get a bit of a lift last week. We can see USD CAD falling after the stronger than expected inflation numbers out of Canada last week on Friday. But since yesterday, the loonie has been reversing those gains. We can see USD CAD moving higher. It briefly rose above the 1.27 level. It's currently trading around 1.2688. We're going to have fourth quarter GDP data out of Canada, so that could give the loonie potentially another lift. But the main concern at the moment is the NAFTA talks, which have moved on to the seventh round this week. There are concerns that that the NAFTA talks aren't going so well, and that is weighing on the loonie at the moment, which in turn is positive for USD CAD. Looking at the Kiwi now, we did have trade numbers out of New Zealand earlier today. New Zealand had its biggest trade deficit in 10 years in January, so that did push the Kiwi lower. It slipped now back below the 0.73 dollar level. It's currently trading down by 0.3% over the day. And finally, looking at today's economic calendar, we can see we're going to have a Eurozone economic sentiments survey coming up shortly, as well as the German flash inflation numbers for February. US durable goods and consumer confidence index will be the focus later in the North American session. As well as Jerome Powell's testimony, that's at 15 hours GMT, but the speech will likely be published sooner than that at 13:30 GMT. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.